For advanced manufacturing to accelerate and thrive in the United States, it will require the active participation of communities, educators, workers, and businesses, as well as federal, state, and local governments.
The lab is pushing a whole new agenda in terms of advanced manufacturing. If you look at after World War II, what really drove our economy was manufacturing, and it's been in steady decline for the past 15 to 20 years. We're starting to see a resurgence, but there's one missing element, which is the workforce. And so what we're doing with this program is tapping into a number of the veterans that are coming back from the wars in Afghanistan and Iraq and training them to be technicians, engineers, scientists, working on the next generation of manufacturing.
The Energy Department's EERE, Advanced Manufacturing Internship Program, provides participants with an accelerated hands-on introduction to the field of advanced manufacturing through a combination of classroom and laboratory activities. Open to U.S. First Robotics participants, undergraduate students, recent graduates, and active or former U.S. military servicemen and women, the program's topics include an introduction to materials, design for advanced manufacturing, printers and fabrication, titanium and ABS plastics, and carbon fiber.
I'm the captain of a robotics team, and so I thought it would be a good way to advance my knowledge.
It's a quickly growing field, and there's lots of new information, and it's really good to be right on the top of that.
According to the Wohlers Report, additive manufacturing, a subtype of advanced manufacturing, will become the most important, most strategic, and most used manufacturing technology ever.
Well, the prospect of working with 3D printing and composites is just a really up-and-coming area of manufacturing, and I felt it was a really good opportunity to get involved in that kind of technology. It's been great so far. The people have been great. It's really, really fascinating what they're doing here. I've been really trying to take it all in, and it's just been a really good experience.
During this six-week program, participants completed classroom instruction at Pellissippi State Community College and several hands-on projects at DOE's Manufacturing Demonstration Facility at ORAU, including the opportunity to design and print in 3D.
Once I transition out of the military, I can take any one of these skills and apply it. Or if I become a design engineer, I can take this technology and know that it's out there, that I can print internal passageways versus a part where I'd have to shave it out and use three different pieces to make one.
We've seen that there's a very strong need in the workforce development area in the additive manufacturing community, and we felt that this was a great opportunity to match up the capabilities of the manufacturing demonstration facility, the needs of their industrial partners, and the transitioning service members and veterans and their great background skill set, and bring it all together and put some well-trained individuals into the hands of the industrial practitioners.